Mom's Scary Dolls, a short story by Erika M Szabo. My mother loved her porcelain-faced dolls and proudly displayed them in a glass cabinet. Although I never played with dolls other than my paper dress-up doll collection, and Mom forbid me to touch her dolls, I liked looking at their pretty dresses. Until she got two new ones. Those really freaked me out. Their dead eyes seemed to follow my every move and made the little hairs stand up on the back of neck, to the point that I did everything I could to avoid going into the room. When I really had to enter the room, I ran to the cabinet and turned those two dolls upside down. Of course, my mother turned them back as soon as she noticed and reminded me again not to touch her dolls. I even tried to leave the cabinet door open so my dog could reach them. Although he shred anything to pieces within seconds, he tiptoed away from the cabinet, and even when I threw one of the dolls to the floor, hoping he would chew them to pieces, he ran out of the room. No matter how many times Dad and I told my mom how creepy those dolls were, she laughed. "Don't be silly. There is nothing creepy about them. They're so pretty." Finally, Grandma came to the rescue 2 weeks later. As soon as she entered the room, she shuddered and told my mom, "Those dolls are cursed. Get rid of them." Mom didn't hesitate and stuffed the dolls into a bag, and to my delight, later that day, she dropped them off at the thrift shop. A few days later, my best friend, Gabby, told me in school, "My mother bought me two dolls for my birthday. They're so creepy looking that I'm scared of them. But I'm more scared to tell my mom that I don't like them. I don't want to hurt her feelings. She was so happy to get those dolls for me." Hearing that, an icy chill ran down my spine, and after school, I went over to Gabby's house. As soon as I looked at the dolls, I recognized them and told Gabby's mom, "My grandmother told us that those dolls are cursed. That's why Mom got rid of them." Gabby's mom grabbed the dolls and threw them into the fireplace. Luckily, the superstition of our parents saved us from being forced to look at those creepy dolls ever again.